Welcome back. Our focus is on Mumbai Development Plan 2034. After 25 years, the city's got a blueprint on which it can base its future development. Couple of things which were critical for the city: a crying need for affordable housing for people living in slums and also those who can't affordable homes, and of course making the city a viable economic destination all over again. Mr. Hiranandani, you heard the counter-argument. This is pretty much the big debate on Mumbai. In terms of why did you need to open up new parcels and not just look at relooking at your slums and redevelopment policies? Second, sir, there's so much skepticism that even by adding this 2,100 plus 330 hectares of land, will you get the affordable housing story right? What do you think?
I think I agree with Chandrasekhar Prabhu that we haven't made successes of the schemes which have already been implemented. So obviously, there is a sort of a doubt whether the future schemes are really going to happen and whether the leadership will be able to use this new policies lucratively in the open lands. My view is very simple, that unless you don't be given an opportunity, you can't win. Second, the kind of redevelopment which has taken place and the kind of slum schemes which have taken place, a lot of negative political intent has fallen into it, with slum lords and other people and political people trying to take advantage of all these things. And there are various people who are in the slum schemes which are actually meant to act as brokers for the deal rather than actually carrying out these things. And hence it has become very, very difficult for regular developers to enter and do these type of schemes successfully. Mm-hmm. Now, if we waited for all these negatives to get out of the situation in the case of redevelopment / SRA schemes, then I think this next 5 years would have been wasted. Hmm. With vacant land being available and government having sufficient money in their kitty for the purposes of development, and the Prime Minister has kept aside a lot of money, almost 50,000 crores of rupees to initiate developments under the Prime Minister's direction for the purposes of this housing, I think a start can be made for the purposes of creating affordable housing. And if on a cost-to-cost basis of construction cost, these people are given houses, then the money will just be rotated and you will really have a zero investments at the end of giving affordable housing, because you'll be giving it at construction cost alone.
All right.
So I think this is a new phenomena, and unless we don't try it, you cannot damn it.
Okay.
So I think the idea is really, if A scheme has not worked, we need to do a B scheme. So all the best to the B scheme. And my view is Devendra Fadnavis will succeed. All the best to him.
All right. The B scheme. Ramesh Nair, what's your opinion? Do you believe that private developers will also partake in some of the land bounty which will be now made available to Mumbaikers? And how do you make sure that, you know, this really remains for affordable housing, does not become speculative, does not become a land grabbing story where, you know, again, there are towers coming up for the rich and famous?
Manisha, this chief minister has at least shown the intent through various infrastructure initiatives and getting this DP passed reasonably quickly that he wants to help. He wants to help the people. What's preventing affordable housing in the country? We know it's single window approvals. We know plans don't get sanctioned for us. Land availability is a big challenge. With this, ND said the 2,400 hectares you mentioned, at least a good amount of land comes into it. It's okay if it's in the peripheries. Nobody wants to stay in South Mumbai. It's fine if some housing, some affordable housing is coming. Again, if you look at what the government has done at the central level, we need to kind of look at this being complementary to some of those, like whether it's the PMAY, whether it's the tax rebates for developers, the ATIB schemes, whether it's the
Ramesh, my question is, are you confident that affordable housing stock will be created in this 2,400 hectares of land which will be released? It's a yes or a no question.
I'm very confident it will happen. It has to be done in a transparent manner, but without PPP, it may not happen.
It may not happen. So the government alone may not be able to do it. All right. Purva, you were saying something that you've studied the DP. I believe it's going to be open to the public for 30 days. And the municipal commissioner will have the powers to rectify if there are any faults found in the plan. Are you comfortable with that openness of the current notified plan?
Yeah, my point was that the state bureaucrats have worked on it for 36 months and the people get 30 days to understand the DP and then file suggestion objection. So I hope that the bureaucrats have really looked in people's minds and then studied and then done the DP.
All right. Because, okay, you're saying that that 36 months is a long time for them to have actually looked at closing all the loopholes. All right, Mr. Prabhu, final question to you. Yes, everything in Mumbai to create affordable housing and to get rid of slums has failed, sir. But why not welcome new land when it's becoming available in a land-starved city?
This has been a cliched statement. Last 35 years, every time a new measure is taken for increase of FSI, we are told this is for the poor. When the Urban Land Ceiling Act was scrapped, we said now affordable housing will come. When the FSI was increased, we were told affordable housing will come. When the mill lands were sold to the greed of the builders, we were told affordable housing will come. When the FSI of the suburbs was increased from 1 to 3, we were told affordable housing has come. At least 31 times the measures were taken and we were told affordable housing will come. Affordable housing never came. The question is, when you make a move to permit land grabbing of government lands, you only do it in the name of the poor, and the poor never get it. It's only slogans. And coming to the Maharashtra government's financial condition, Niranjan knows very well, he's my friend, that we are more than 3.5 lakh crore in debt. Where does the government have money? The government doesn't have money every month. I very closely monitor happenings in the Mantralaya. Giving salaries is a major problem to the government. And you're saying there is money? There is no money with the government. I'm sorry. This money has to come from the land, and when it comes from the land, it is not going to be affordable. We want affordable housing. We want rationalization in this, prices.
Okay.
We want that DCR should be promoted in such a way to promote affordable housing. But that's not what is happening.
Okay. All right, Mr. Prabhu, we've completely run out of time. I think you have made your point very strongly, sir. Very strongly, sir. And I think that skepticism right now is well-founded because look at the history of Mumbai. Affordable housing still remains a big pipe dream. And of course, people living in slums, the numbers aren't reducing. Niranjan Hiranandani, Ramesh Nair, Chandrasekhar Prabhu and Purva, thank you very much for joining me. I mean, Mumbai is looking at becoming an employment generation hub all over again, creating affordable housing stock. But the past, at least, is something that doesn't give people a lot of confidence. So skepticism will remain till we see some on-ground implementation of the Development Plan 2034, as has been notified today. And of course, 1 month left for the government and for the public to actually come out with any big faults in the plan. So we don't take it as final, but almost final. I'm signing off now. We will keep this conversation going in the coming days. Thanks so much for joining me.